This is the most complex, largest, biggest, ever challenging telescope ever built in the world. It took a lot of scientific research and it actually began around 1989, but the actual works actually started around 1996. The James Webb Space Telescope. It was launched last year in 2021, towards the end of 2021 actually. And today we're going to discuss the technology behind it. Hey, you are most welcome, and if you're new here, please subscribe before we continue. And my name is Ronnie Otoire, aka Afroboy Tex, and I'm glad that you chose this particular video. Do you know that the James Webb Telescope is actually running on JavaScript? Actually, this article by The Verge will blow out your mind. JavaScript turns out to be the programming language the web developers used. And yeah, that's it. And we all know how JavaScript is slow, and why would they choose JavaScript in the first place? As you can see, according to the manuscript PDF, we shall look at this later on. They are just detailing how actually they use the language. Now, for example, the language that the scripts are written in is actually called NumberScript. It was actually released in 2003, almost two decades ago. The people who can vote who weren't born the software, yes, this is very true. And if you look at when exactly they had used the language, you can see that the 5 version of the script was actually launched, and they used the language in 2004 when the construction of the telescope began, though the main works began in 1986. Now I think the implementation of the technology or the languages to be used, and this is when they began. So why would they choose JavaScript as a language? Yet we know this is a very critical mission operation, and we would want something that is actually stable. If you scroll down to the article, you'd see that they actually implemented C++. This is the script processor, and it's written in C++, of course, which is known for being very good with systems and what language one would actually recommend if you're going to build a spacecraft. But someone blew JavaScript into space. Why would NASA do that? So let's go to the working of the working of the script, and we see how exactly. This is the PDF document. I'll leave it in the description. As we see here, the science instrument control, which is the actually kind of like the heart, because these images that are being beamed towards the Earth from the James Webb Space Telescope come because of what is happening around here. It's kind of like a web-based browser-like scripting language that you use, and that's what they use, the script TS numbers, which is kind of a JavaScript interpreter. And the script processor, as we saw, it is actually C++ that is actually running this and calling this. So if you scroll down, this is what we saw in the article. The script processor calls the JavaScript engine, and then this is what now is executed. The dictionary JavaScripts and the commands and all those things are actually happening right here. And it seems that they didn't upgrade or design to the latest technologies, because that language has since gone or vanished into air. I came up with I found an interesting Hacker News thread, and you saw someone trying to point out the same issue. A bankrupt company, as we call it, no longer working, it's not defunct. And then you see someone who was actually part of the team implementing that interpreter. He was also shocked because it says I was blown away at the amount of the research NASA did covering all the control language options. And of course, glad they selected theirs. The language itself wasn't so much important. Adequate performance, robustness, memory use, productivity, and extreme quality control. And you could be a developer and then you just design or develop something and then boom, someone gets to use or gets to love what you've just designed, and they get to use it and you stop actually even updating or upgrading that particular tool that you actually developed. And that's what is actually happening here, because it seems that's what NASA went in for. As you can see, a JavaScript is not so common in science. Yes, this is very true. And using someone is also confirming the same thing, because JavaScript I think was introduced around 1995 as live script. So the actual works beginning in 1996, JavaScript wasn't really something that you would consider to use. And moving on, these are just comments that I'm reading through this Hacker News thread. You want to wonder why you would want to use Python? No, Python is extremely slow for this type of purpose. Maybe it could help out somewhere, but bringing or beaming back images back to the earth, I wouldn't recommend Python. I would recommend something like C or C++. As a person, as a developer. And if you're new here, please subscribe. That's it for today. Stay blessed.